Good evening and welcome to the men's championship game of the 2016 Ross Sheppard High School Totem Hoop Classic. ICU Video Productions and Ross Sheppard are proud to bring you the tournament championship games from this annual preseason tournament, which has become a holiday hoops tradition in the City of Champions. The Totem Hoop Classic is one of the biggest preseason basketball tournaments in Western Canada and draws teams from throughout Alberta each year. Good evening, everyone. My name is Kevin Donnan, and I'm pleased to be joined tonight by Robin Fleckenstein, who will help analyze these games, and our cameraman, Connor O'Donovan. We began earlier tonight with the women's final. Jasper Place won the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic women's title with a 66-36 win over the St. Albert Skyhawks. And we finished the Totem Hoop Championship doubleheader with the men's final featuring the Magrath Zeniths against the host Ross Sheppard Thunderbirds. Robin, we are in for a good one tonight.
Oh yeah, we are in for a treat.
Ross Sheppard in their traditional light blue, the Magrath Zeniths.
Baby blue is for championships. Coach Youngs will not let them wear their baby blues unless they are in the championship.
There you go. Looking very Tar Heel-esque. Magrath now starts out quick. And number five, Payson Blackmore. Hits!
Oh, nice.
Big three to start things out.
We did get a correction from the Magrath coach, the Zeniths.
The Zeniths, thank you.
I would not have known that.
The Zeniths now, the T-Birds. We'll start with their first offensive possession and a nice
great
move.
Look.
Good drive to the hoop.
Some nice patience there inside.
Adiola Alupino, the grade 12 forward for the T-Birds. Early stage now. These two teams' first championship games of the season, of course, preseason tournament.
Some great help defense there from Shep. Good rotations inside. Nice push in transition. You're going to see a lot of that from Shep tonight. They love to push the ball in transition. They want to score fast and they want to score early.
That pass intended for number one at Tara Magog, grade 11 guard. And they'll kick things out now. Keon Moore for three, and it won't go. Rebound by number 14, Sam Payne of the Zeniths. Number five, Payson Blackmore.
Those are two former provincial kids, Keon Moore and Atur. They both were fantastic pieces of the U15 provincial team 2 years ago.
Magrath now tries the four, tries the three, and good defense by Shep and the reverse. Good patience.
That's some fantastic rebounding in there, just going after the ball and being smart and being aggressive with your body.
Number 11, Taylor Cook converts for Magrath. That's number 13, Alaf Alaf. Big three-pointer for the T-Birds. As both teams looking to shoot out the lights tonight. 2016 Totem Hoop Classic, men's championship game. Great to have you along with us. And Taylor Cook, some hard work down below. And this Magrath team owning the glass early.
They are just gritty.
Hoop in the harm, number 11, Taylor Cook. This Magrath team, you got to be impressed, Robin, right off the start.
Oh, yeah.
Doing fantastic, unbelievable work on the glass.
They're just really hitting the glass hard and getting in there and using their bodies to create position. The more times you can tip the ball, the more chances you have at getting that rebound, and that's what they are showing us right now.
Cook converts his solo shot. Beautiful drive. That's number four, Keon Moore. 5'10" guard in grade 11 for the T-Birds.
And that's what Keon does so well for the T-Birds. He just loves to push that pace, and he is great at using his body in transition to create distance.
Good hustle play by number 13, Aloth, the 6'5", grade 12 forward, number 13 for the T-Birds. Get box, box, box. This is the one we've been waiting for. Magrath started out with a big win over Skona in their first game. There's a three, and hits. Number 14, Sam Payne, the 6'3" forward in grade 11. Down south, Magrath just 30 kilometers south of Lethbridge, so right on right on the border. Here's Keon Moore now, kicks it over.
Magrath just has some really big athletes. They're big physical boys, so they are really setting the tempo physically.
Blocking foul on number 14, Sam Payne. Non-shooting foul. T-Birds will kick it back out. Here's Moore, number four. Watch. Watch the ball handling of Moore right there. Beautiful drive down the lane. Won't go. And there's Magrath with a tough rebound. That's number 11, Taylor Cook. And he's had a busy night. Oh, big, big defense. Number 13. A lot for the T-Birds. There's
That's
a foul.
A tough one for Alath in transition. I think he was fairly straight up, but really, there's nothing much you can do in that circumstance.
What's this?
They say Alath did not have position. Some confusion here.
What's going on?
In terms of substitutions. Number eight, Mason Stock will shoot a pair here. Robin, maybe you can bring us up to speed. What was the issue between the...
Oh, just a bloody nose there on the sideline. They just needed to get him out of the game as quickly as they could. Get that dealt with, and then he can come back to play.
That's number 11, Olopino. He's got to go in for some repairs. There's a three for
shot.
The T-Birds, and there's a laugh. From
he loves
downtown.
That three. He's a 6'5" frame, but he just wants to drop that tray. He does not feel comfortable inside, and that is his look.
Magrath now. Moving the ball well. Here's Cook looking to spot up.
Good look.
Nice movement. Good ball movement. Good feed down to number 14, Sam Payne, who picks up a couple in the paint. Here's a three for the T-Birds. Won't go. Battle for the ball and the rebound. And that's number 14, Sam Payne. He'll bring it up for the Zeniths. He'll drive and he'll shoot two. So right now, little less than halfway through this first quarter, and you've got to be impressed with the pace of Magrath right now.
Yeah, there's no question. They're doing a fantastic job of pushing in transition. They're making the T-Birds pay for some poor rotations in transition, and it's really showing. Like, the number of fouls right now, it's difficult for the T-Birds.
6:11 to go here, opening quarter of the 2016 Men's Senior Final here at the Totem Hoop Classic. Magrath on top, 16-10. Our friends from way down south. Step back by number five, Michael Long of the T-Birds.
The fans like that one.
That was a big shot, big step back by Long.
That was a great job keeping his body under control to step back into that look. That's a tough shot to make.
Magrath, no, that's number seven, won't go. Good rebound by Magrath. Really good work and good hustle.
Just relentless rebounding here from Magrath. They do not give up on the boards. They are not worried about a missed shot. They are just going after the next one.
Mason Stock with that big conversion, and the T-Birds down low. Foul. Actually, a change in possession, so it is an offensive foul.
Oh, and that's a last second there. He just picked it up.
And Magrath will inbound. 5:22 to go, 6-point lead. And the nerves have got to be, if you're the host of the tournament, coming in as a coach, Robin, what are you telling, you're the host team, that is there a little bit of extra pressure there?
There's no question that there's definitely some nerves at play here. As we have said earlier in the women's game, it's early in the season and there's a lot on the line, and of course everybody wants to win, so that's for sure a determinant, but I'd say at the same time, what I would say to my kids if we were coming into this game is, hey, we made it here. We've earned the right to be here, so let's play like we're ready to be here.
Foul on number eight, Mason Stock of the Zeniths. Ball was fed to Bradley Bright, number nine, non-shooting foul, and the T-Birds will inbound. Here's number four, Keon Moore. There's a laugh. Number 13, oh, nice crossover by McGaugh. More good ball movement by the T-Birds, and Moore with the drive. Putback won't go. And the T-Birds will shoot two. Number nine, Bradley Bright, will shoot two. T-Birds down, Thunderbirds down early here by eight, 4:40 to go in the opening quarter. Magrath up 20-13, 4:40 to go. Glad you're along with us. I guess we could say throughout the world, Robin, really, on the on the World Wide Web, of course. Yeah. You know what? Ross Sheppard brings you the world and brings you some of the finest basketball in Western Canada. And, of course, this is a preseason tournament, so we're already seeing some fantastic basketball, and the regular season hasn't even started, but this is a real treat.
I think right now you can also see like that desperation level from both teams. They both want to compete. They both want to work hard. And when you've been training with just your teammates for a whole month, it can get a little bit messy.
Sure.
So they finally are getting a chance to get after each other here.
Get a little bit boring, too, at times. So
oh, yeah.
Foul
away
from the ball.
It can get a little bit overly aggressive.
That's right. You need to lean on someone else. Couple of T-Birds check in.
You don't want to injure your teammates.
No.
But you do want to compete. So there is that aggression that happens. And it's nice to see both teams finally getting a chance to bring that competition level.
There's Bright. He loses the handle on the ball. Magrath on the transition over to number five, Blackmore. The point guard, Payson Blackmore. He's with Tallestrup, number seven. That's his shooting guard. Doing great work. Leans back. Won't go. Rebound by Bright. Here's Keon Moore, number four. Over to number seven, and a big block by the Zeniths.
That's a tough thing in transition when you extend your body and you leave yourself no other thing to do than shoot. It's an easy timing for a shot blocker.
Extra step by number 13, Josh Jensen, the 6'6 center from grade 12 down in Magrath. Just over 4 minutes to go. Magrath up 20-14 here in the opening quarter of the final game of this Totem Hoop Classic, the 24th annual here at Ross Shep. Here's Moore now driving, and it won't go, but he will shoot two from the line. Robin, what an outstanding tournament in terms of volunteers, student volunteers. What a great group of kids and staff here at Ross Shep who put on this tournament every year, and it's such a first-class operation in terms of you can't walk into this place without being greeted by a student. Mm-hmm. It's just a great atmosphere.
You know what? We're so lucky to have such fantastic kids here that are willing to give their time. And basketball is kind of like religion here at Shep, which is an exciting thing. So they are all just so thrilled to be a part of this very prestigious tournament. And they really just want to be here to witness this majesty.
Fight for the ball. Loose ball. That's Bradley Bright, number nine, down on the floor with number five, Payson Blackmore. Possession over to the T-Birds. So that's a big change of possession for the Thunderbirds, who want to settle things down a little bit, Robin. Off to start here.
Yeah, they just need to be patient, to be finding those easy open looks just like that. And there's nothing wrong with that shot.
Moore can't convert. There is a foul. Looks like it's on number 11, Taylor Cook.
Looks like Keon just got a little bit nervous underneath the net there. Didn't need that dribble. Could have just gone straight up and finished. But, you know, that's the mentality that can come when you are in the final of a big tournament.
Head coach Dave Young's now having a chat. Number seven, Bahar Kamal, will shoot a pair. Grade 12 forward, 6'2". As we mentioned, this is one of the finest preseason basketball tournaments in Western Canada. Glad you're along with us. ICU Video, we do not podcast. We procast, and we cover amateur sports professionally. 3 minutes to go here in this opening quarter. Good opening quarter, too. The Zeniths have come out really dominated on the glass. That's number 14, Sam Payne. He's had a tremendous quarter. He stops and hits a bucket from about 15 feet out. Here's Moore now driving. Up with the left hand, won't go. Rebounded by Blackmore of Magrath. He'll bring the ball up the floor. He'll stop, try the three, and just short.
Just a little short.
There's Kamal, number seven.
The refs are really reeling these boys in tonight. You can see that level of physicality, that level of aggression, and they are trying to keep things under wraps here. Can be difficult, but it's the only way to make sure that things don't escalate.
Kamal draws the foul, checking in for the T-Birds. Number two, Munir Amar, 5'10" guard in grade 11. Magrath with the 7 point, with the 7 point lead, and you've got to give the Zeniths a lot of credit. They've come out and have really established themselves both in terms of rebounding, both on the offensive glass and, you know, on defense. They've really done a good job rebounding.
Yeah, there's no question that Magrath is really setting the tone physically right now, which is, I think, a little bit surprising for the T-Birds. They were not prepared for this, and you can see that they're back on their heels a little bit with the physicality from these Magrath players. But, I mean, they have good, big physical frames, and they are just not afraid to get in there and bang around. So we're going to see a lot of this, I think, the whole game.
Payne misses that shot, so the ball travels out of bounds, and Shep will take over now. That's Amar called on the travel. So he takes the extra steps with 2:06 to go. Been a fantastic tournament so far. Ross Shep, of course, won big over their crosstown rivals, McNally. 25-point victory over the Tigers in their first game. And the...
Oh, a three in the key call.
That's an oldie but a goodie. Josh Jensen called on the old three in the key. Hanging out a little too long on the doorstep.
Usually by the time you get a three in the key call, you've been building a house in there for a little bit too long. So I think that that's probably, there's
some
merit behind
like a
that.
True coach, building a house in there. I love it. Here we go.
That's
there's
a nice
thaw
shot.
With his shot, and it won't go. A foul called here.
I think there's a little bit of desperation here from the Ross Shep T-Birds, just trying to go through bodies instead of becoming crafty and getting around those defenders.
That Bradley
was a
Bright.
A good box out, and he just tried to go right through them.
Bit of a desperation move there by Bradley Bright going over the top. And now number 14, Sam Payne, 6'3" forward in grade 11 from Magrath, will shoot too. Head coach of the Magrath Zeniths is Danny Balderson, their assistant coach, Russ Sommerfeld. Their manager is Lane Barnett, and we want to thank the Magrath contingent for making their way up to the City of Champions.
It's a long trip, but it's good. It's really great, especially in these preseason tournaments, to get to a different place and play competition that you wouldn't get, because really there's no way they'd see them in the regular season.
Well, and for a coach, early in this season, there's Bradley Bright nearly cashing in. But as a coach, when you get the opportunity in a preseason tournament to go out on the road, that's a really good, in terms of team bonding, that's something that you can't replace. When you get that opportunity to get out on the road and it's just you and the team, or it's just the team together, that's a great way to start off the season.
You can't mimic those long drives in a sweaty van.
That's true. That's how a team forms.
It's what builds family. It's what builds character. And, you know, you might have to cuddle a little longer with someone than you'd like. But
that's right.
No, I would say, I mean, as a player, we did the long road trip once a year. We would go to Quebec, and that was a 14-hour drive from Nova Scotia. So that 14-hour drive in a 16-passenger van, you're getting to know your teammates pretty well
situation. Great drive by Blackmore, number 5. And a steal now by number 7, Brady Tollestrup.
Just a little rushed on that attack there. It was a nice penetration to draw two, but then no patience from Manier on that
Sam Payne, smooth as glass, steps back and pops one from about 20 feet. And Magrath making a statement here in this opening quarter. 10-point lead, 35 to go, 28-18. Magrath Zeniths on top here, the opening quarter of this Totem Hoop men's final. T-Birds now, big
nice
rebound.
Oh.
Another great rebound in the T-Birds.
From a grade 10.
With the putback.
That was, where is he?
That is number 00.
He's got a different number in the baby blues.
That is Medit Lewis. So he changed numbers on us, fooled us. Certainly doesn't take much to fool me, but he was number 8, but Medit Lewis number 00. What did he make a fantastic play?
He's a great young athlete, and he really, really works hard. You're going to see a lot from him today in terms of just hustle plays.
Down in the paint and hits. That's number 13, Josh Jensen, the center. The big guy, 6'6". And McGrath finishes this quarter with a 10-point lead, 30-20, over the Ross Shep T-Birds, the host team. Now you go into this second quarter. What is Dave Youngs telling his team?
Well, you know, 10 points isn't that much. I mean, it's a small differential, so you have to be patient. You have to kind of rewind here and go back to what are the basics that we are trying to prepare for. I think right now Shep is being out-rebounded on both ends of the floor, so they have to become more aggressive with their box outs, more tenacious with the body on the rebound, and just going after loose balls. They can't be going through people, because that's when you're going to get those easy foul calls, which obviously they had a little bit of trouble with there in the first quarter. So they have to be disciplined with where they are on the floor.
And be patient. And you also mentioned don't rush, because you mentioned a couple of times when we were talking about the Thunderbirds, you were saying, you know, they're rushing some shots, they're rushing some box outs, they're rushing some rebounds.
Yeah.
We saw Bradley Bright go over the top, commit a shooting foul. So right now it's just like take a breath, get the butterflies down. And
yeah, I think right now we're just seeing a lot of excitement and a lot of nerves. And what Shep needs right now is to take a step back and just breathe. Go back to what their team focus is for the game and take a deep breath.
Play strong, fundamental half-court basketball. And for Danny Balderson of McGrath, he's telling his team, just stick with the formula.
Oh, yeah. He's just saying we got to keep being the first one to loose balls. We've got to keep being the ones setting the tone physically. We've got to keep being the ones who are getting those third and fourth and fifth shots from our rebounding. So that is key for them right now.
And as you mentioned, McGrath, in terms of both hustle and physicality, they have really dominated on the glass, both in their own end and on the offensive boards. So with this timeout winding down, we will move into the second quarter. The McGrath Zeniths, the visiting team, here up by 10 as we open the second quarter of the 24th annual Totem Hoop Classic. Glad you're along with us on this ICU video procast. Kevin Donnan along with Robin Fleckenstein and our cameraman Connor O'Donovan. Great to have you along with us from Ross Sheppard High School in Edmonton. So
a quick turnover that can really change the momentum here. So we'll see how Shep is able to capitalize on this quick turnover.
Keon Moore now will drive. Number four can't go. Rebound by number four, John Jones of the Zena. Steal now.
Oh, Medeet. Nice take.
Beautiful. Beautiful lay-in by Medeet Lewis from grade 10, the 6'1" guard.
That's him doing what he does well, you know, just being the garbage man. Sometimes it's not a shiny job, but, hey, someone's got to do it.
Zeniths now. Try to lay that one in. That's number seven, Tallistrup. Here we go with the T-Birds and big defense. Number four, John Jones. The solid putback. T-Birds will maintain possession, but big block by number four, John Jones. He checks out of the ball game. In comes number eight, Mason Stock, for the Zeniths. Bright to inbound to McGaugh, number one. Now gives it over to Moore, who will drive through the paint. Nearly converts there. Ends up picking up a little piece of floor there, number nine. Levi Steed, looks like the foul is on Steed, number nine. 9:08 to go here for opening 52 seconds. Moore hits his first. The 5'10" guard in grade 11 for the T-Birds, and he hits both of his. So now the T-Birds chipping away at that big lead, just six now. The differential.
That differential between 10 and 6, though, that's a huge difference. Two possessions versus four. I mean, you feel like you're right in it. 6 points is nothing in basketball. That's the beauty.
Big turnover here on the travel on Mason Stock guilty of the extra step. So now the Thunderbirds have a chance to take the momentum away from the Zeniths, who had as good an opening quarter as you can ask for, really.
Yes, I would totally agree with that, Kevin.
Good step over by Moore. It's number 7, Kamal. Back out to Moore now. He'll step back, drive, beautiful. Can't get it to go, rebound by Steed number 9.
You can hear how the crowd liked that one, the ooh and the ah. They sold that one.
little bit of air came out of the gym on that one. That was a beautiful little crossover and step back by Moore. And as you were talking, when you are the host team, you have to expect a little bit of nerves, and now mm-hmm. you can see the T-Birds are settling down a bit.
Yes, they're finally getting back into their game. Obviously, Coach Young's did a good job of rallying the troops in that timeout, and they're ready to play.
Offensive foul committed by number 13, Josh Jensen, center for the Zeniths. And the possession arrow will change now for the T-Birds. Here's Moore. Oh, what a beautiful feed.
Oh.
But the lay-in won't go. That was number 13, Aloth. He couldn't convert. And Moore. Moore picks up the foul. More importantly, number 7, Brady Tallestrup. Inbound now by the Zeniths. There's number 5. Over to Tallestrup now. Tallestrup at the top of the key. Kicks out to Steed. Blackmore now for 3, and it won't go. Big rebound by Lewith. And the T-Birds now will break.
Shep taking care of more of those rebounds now. You can see they had a good
shot
about that.
Oh, and a beautiful 3 from downtown. Number 4. Keon Moore, you can't leave him alone like that.
No, he's a great player, and great players are going to hit those easy open shots.
Moore, the southpaw, the lethal lefty with the 3. Big drive by number 7, Tallestrup. Good team defense by Shep, and the Zeniths with a little bit of a press, but now they back away. Moore now getting a little more comfortable. You can see him settling up. Long 3 won't go. Loose ball, and it's a battle and a real mishmash of bodies as Levi Steed is in there along with number 11, Adiola Olupino from Shep. Zeniths take a timeout here, 7:14 to go in the second quarter.
And a three-point game.
Three-point game, and this is exactly what we anticipated. Of course, Magrath won big over Lillian Osborne. They won by 16. Ross Shep really took it to Edmonton Christian Academy, 83-59. So it's when you see two teams have the run that they've both been on, the two games, this is exactly what we anticipated, the two best teams in the tournament. And so far, the championship game has delivered on all cylinders what we expected. Only a three-point game. Shep came out a little sluggish, maybe a little nervous, but now everybody's settled down and we're in for a real treat.
Yeah, there's no question that you can see both teams are starting to just get into the rhythm that they want to play with, and you can see Shep just calming down and getting into the things that they like to do.
Of course, this year Ross Shep will be part of the 15-team Metro Division I pool in the 2016-17 regular season, and ICU Video, of course, wants to encourage all of our viewers, get out and support amateur basketball, be it at the CIS level with the U of A Golden Bears, or check your local high school, Metro Athletics in Edmonton, do an internet search, find the schedule near you and a team near you, support amateur basketball in Alberta, and we're in, as I mentioned, we're in for a real treat here as part of this preseason tournament. And it's great to watch these young athletes. Of course, just earlier tonight, we had the women's senior championship game, and that was a big one for Jasper Place, 66-36 over the St. Albert Skyhawks. Back to live action now. Keon Moore, number 4 for Shep. Deals, Foul called on Adeola Alupino, number 11.
I didn't catch that one, but he said it was an offensive foul, so he must have been holding on a screen. It's so easy to do when you really just want to get your teammate open, but the refs are really calling a tight one here tonight.
Here's the feed down low to Levi Steed, kicks it back out. That's Blackmore with a nice move, nice turn. He'll fire, won't go, collects his own rebound. Dave Young's the T-Bird coach, calling on his team, you got to get to that loose ball, got to get to those rebounds.
Yeah, well, really, I mean, that can kill you, right? Playing 24 seconds of defense is tough. Playing 48 seconds of defense is really difficult. It makes you tired, and really you lose focus, you lose control, and the more offensive boards there are, the more opportunities, obviously, that a team is getting to score.
Here's Blackmore, number 5 for the Zeniths. 10 on the shot clock. Good defense by Moore, number 4. He'll drive Blackmore. A little runner won't go. Loose ball now. Here's Blackmore back with it in the paint. Rebounding. Tenacious rebounding by Magrath. That's number 8.
I counted 5 O boards there.
Mason Stock.
That's tough to defend, right? 5 O boards, 5 missed blockouts, 5 new opportunities to score. Really, every time they get the ball back, their percentages to score are going to go through the roof. So,
as a coach, that'll keep you awake at night. Number 8, Mason Stock, the grade 10 forward, 6'3", for the Zeniths.
Yeah, that and unforced turnovers.
Yeah, that's right.
Those are the two worst
all of
things.
A sudden, you'll be
missed box outs and unforced turnovers.
All of a sudden, you'll be discovering gray hairs. Here
yes.
we go now. Age it a little bit.
I blame my players for both my gray hairs and my wrinkles.
There you go.
They know they're responsible. So.
You bet. Of course, Robin, a coach here at Ross Shep. There's Kamal with the shot from the baseline. Good rebound. Kicks back out, won't go. Another good rebound by Shep. Here's Moore, number 4.
Great job by Alath. Alath in there just getting a piece of the ball and getting it back out to the point for his teammates to have a chance to
3 from
score.
The corner won't go, and that's picked up by number 8, Stock.
Oh, we got
collision
in
right
middle.
In the middle. Here's Blackmore with the drive, and it won't go. Kicks back out to Moore. Now the T-Birds will run.
Good decision to pull it out, though, and get into an offensive set there.
McGaugh misses from the corner. Magrath, the Zeniths rebound. Here's Blackmore, number 5, with the run, and tried for the lay-in and a battle for the ball. It's number 9, Levi Steed, getting better acquainted with Alath, who's done a sensational job rebounding for the Thunderbirds.
Yeah, he's clever. You can see that grade 12 cleverness. He's just getting there and get a piece of that ball. That's all you need for the rebound to come back yours.
And what a smart play by number 4, Keon Moore, as you mentioned. They're on the fast break. The drive or the lay-in isn't there, so what does he do? Stops, slows everything down. Very
yeah.
intelligent player.
Exactly. When you're coming in transition, what you're looking for is some kind of advantage. A 2-on-1, a 3-on-2, a 4-on-3. You want to score in advantage situations. But if it's not there, there's no reason to force when you don't have all your players. So that was a smart play to pull it out.
Ater Magog couldn't bring in the ball, and it travels out of bounds. So possession arrow now for Magrath. That's number 14, Sam Payne. Spots up, tries a 3, won't go. Here's Moore for the T-Birds. Moore now back out to number 6. Grayson Youngs won't go. Rebounded again by the Zeniths, who have done well on the defensive glass as well. Here's Blackmore, number 5. Talk about the catalyst of this team. What a great job rebounding. That's number 8, Mason Stock.
They are just relentless. They do not stop. They want that ball, and they're going to get it at any cost.
Levi Steed with the put away for the Zeniths, who've now expanded their lead to 7 points here. 4.5 to go in a very entertaining first half. This Zeniths team, they hustle.
Yep. There's no question that they just keep going. They're like the Energizer Bunny out there. I'm getting tired watching them.
Mason Stock with and a great work by Blackmore and Mason Stock with the easy lay-in.
I think Magrath is just getting so many easy looks inside because they move well. They move well off each other, and they're just hitting those boards.
Alath with the long two won't go. Rebound gathered in by Steed, and now Blackmore content to bring the ball up slowly. Use that clock. 3:50 to go here, second quarter. 10 on the shot clock. Fed down. That's stock number 8. Won't go. Number 6, Parker Clifton. Couldn't get that one to fall. Here's Moore, number 4 for the T-Birds. Now over to Alot for 3, and it won't. It bounces back out. Gathered by Steed again, number 9. Here's Blackmore.
Good, clever play.
And the beautiful lay-in from Moore with the assist over to Alath. Alath, and as you mentioned, what a heads-up play by Alath, number 13.
Yep, he just lulled that defender into a false sense of relaxation, and then as soon as he was relaxed, he picked his pocket.
There's Payne, number 14, smooth with a big three-point.
That is a tough, contested jump shot. Nothing more a Turk could have done there, and he hits it anyway, right in his face.
You can't beat a great shot, and that was what Sam Payne just finished with. Absolutely smooth. Here's Moore now, the little runner. Rebound by number 8, Mason Stock. Magrath now with a 10-point lead, 39-29. Pass, ball rolls out. Possession will now go to the T-Birds. We're down by 10 with 2:23 to go in the second quarter. Timeout called by the T-Birds, and for Dave Youngs, this is a good time to call
yes.
a timeout.
Oh, no question. He needs to talk to his boys right now.
And what is Coach Young saying to the Thunderbirds at this point?
Well, if you look at the play that's going on, really, Magrath is having an easy time defensively with their rebounding. Shep has no one that's crashing the boards. Shep has no one that is getting in there and fighting for those loose balls. And Magrath has 5 boys every time, 5 bodies in there in the paint that are willing to sacrifice themselves. So Shep has to become either more disciplined with box outs or more aggressive on the O boards. I'd say a combination of the two would really help.
Shep trying to win their third Totem Hoop Classic in 4 years. Of course, the T-Birds have won their own tournament 6 times since 2005. They had repeat titles most recently in 2013 and 2014, so they're trying to make it 3 out of 4 with a win here tonight at the T-Bird Gym here at Ross Sheppard High School. Of course, Ross Shep celebrating their 60th anniversary next year in 2017, and we've talked about it already, but the renovations are sensational. The school is one of Edmonton's classic high schools, mm-hmm. and I mean, really, the T-Bird Gym, it can be argued, and maybe we'll hear from some Jasper Place people, or who knows, but really, the Thunderbird Gym is the birthplace of basketball in Edmonton.
I would say that, I mean, even those from other schools agree that our large gym, and it'll be even better when it's refurbished, but our large gym is one of few where you have a full stadium seating on both sides of the gym, and that's not something, the energy in that gym, you can't replicate that. So
it is a fan. I mean, when you really want to, if you really want to, you know, get down to brass tacks here, the T-Bird Gym is a legendary arena
yes.
in this city
yes.
in terms of, you know, for basketball. And, I mean, Ross Sheppard has got such a fantastic tradition in terms of basketball in this city. So here we go, back to live action. That's number 5, Michael Long at point guard. Drive won't go. Here's a laugh. It's not a laugh, sorry. 3 from the corner, Michael Long, the grade 12 guard. And that's a big 3 for the T-Birds. They needed to hit that as the Shep reserves, a lot of the reserves are on now.
I mean, a great thing about Shep this year is, and we saw it earlier with the JP women, they are a very deep program this year. They have a lot of talent, even when you go into the second and third string. So
there is a big 3 by Payson Blackmore. He responds back. Loose ball now.
Great
here
hustle.
Comes the Zeniths. Big hustle and won't go. Rebound by Bradley Bright, number 9.
You know, it can be difficult to hustle back when there's a steal like that in transition, but it's great to see contesting those shots, because that is the difference between an easy make and a tough miss.
Good work in the corner. It's number 5, Michael Long. He draws the foul, and he will shoot 2 here in the final minute, just under the final minute here in the second quarter, with the Magrath Zeniths up by 10. Bit of a surprise here. Ross Shep being very accommodating hosts so far. And Coach Youngs would think maybe a little too accommodating at this point.
I think he would agree with you.
Sure, 9-point lead here, final minute of the opening half of a very entertaining half. This has been preseason basketball, but you wouldn't know it. Both of these two teams, can't wait to see these two in midseason form. Uh-huh. So the Zeniths draw the foul. That's number 7, Brady Tollestrup. Foul on number 5, Michael Long of the T-Birds.
I think the nice thing to see with Magrath, I mean, they are great rebounders, but I think they are also very, very detail-oriented. You can see when they come down the floor, they run their offense, they listen to their coach, they're in the right spots, they're hustling to the ball. Those are all important details when you're coming down to a championship program.
Tollestrup hits both of his foul shots. And there's the drive down low to Bright. Kicks it back out to Long. Now back out. And a 3 will not go.
Great rebound, though.
Good rebounding by the T-Birds. Kicks back out. And an offensive foul called on Bradley Bright as he gets called on the charge over there. Just underneath the hoop, and Magrath. 28 seconds to go, and an 11-point lead.
And they're going to hold this
ball
in. What
a four-second differential, I guess, on the
slow down the possession here.
Four-second
differential. They want to use as much time as they can so that Shep has less time to get a shot there at the end of the half.
Blackmore now for 3, and it won't go off the glass. Loose ball. Possession will stay with the Zeniths, who will get one more shot. Magrath looks to call a timeout here. Danny Balderson, the head coach, calls timeout.
It's a smart play.
6.2 seconds to go, 11-point lead. And this Magrath team looks confident and calm. And they have, if we're writing the story of the first half, we'd be talking about the rebounding.
Yeah, there's no question. I mean, the hustle plays and the rebounding and just tips on passes. I mean, all of those little things seem like minute details, but really they add up to be such a huge factor.
Absolutely, and with 31 seconds to go in the timeout, 6.2 seconds left on the clock, Magrath with an 11-point lead. Magrath has had a very strong tournament coming in. Of course, they took down the Strathcona Lords, beat Lillian Osborne by 16, and then came into this final tonight. Of course, Shep had 2 big wins, a 25-point win over McNally in their first game. They then went into the championship semifinal and beat Edmonton Christian Academy by 24. But here, they are down by 11, 6.2 seconds to go in the opening half, and a very entertaining half here at the T-Bird Gym. Zeniths now inbounding. Tollestrup. Clifton now. Travel on Clifton, so the T-Birds now with 3.7 may get a shot away, or hopefully get a shot away with 3.7, so we'll see what they do. Bradley Bright here, number 9, will inbound for Ross Shep. And there's the shot, and the runner just about
That's
goes.
That's a great opportunity.
Absolutely. That was number 3, Julian Vox. And with that, That brings the first half to a close. The Magrath Zeniths here in the opening half of the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic here at Ross Sheppard High School. The Magrath Zeniths lead 44-33. And when we come back, we will have the second half of this men's division championship game. Be back in just a few moments from the T-Bird Gym. Welcome back to the second half of the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic Senior Men's Division Championship game here at the beautiful T-Bird Gym at Ross Sheppard High School. Of course, Kevin Donnan along with you from ICU Video. I'm joined by Robin Fleckenstein, my analyst for this game. Of course, we did the Women's Championship game earlier tonight, and this Totem Hoop Classic here at Ross Shep, one of the biggest preseason basketball tournaments in Western Canada. But Robin, you would not know that this is a preseason tournament. These two teams have come in and look like they're in midseason form. Of course,
yeah,
Magrath.
They look good.
Magrath comes in with an 11-point lead to start this second half. What does Ross Shep have to do to win this ball game?
I think right now Shep just really needs to be hitting the of all of those loose balls, and they need to be the first one to every rebound.
That's ball gonna be fed down low.
That's going to be a big determinant of what happens in this half.
Ball fed down low to McGaugh. In terms of foul trouble, Bradley Bright of the T-Birds has three. Olopinio, number 11 of Ross Shep, has three. So Coach Dave Youngs, nice little runner by McGaugh, number one. That's a good way to start for the host T-Birds.
Yep.
Cut that lead to nine now. Blackmore, number five, the engine of the Zenith offense here. Great first half for the point guard.
Oh, great read there on the back door.
Beautiful back door feed by the Zenith. Big rejection, number 13.
I think our fans like that one a little bit.
A lot. That'll get the home crowd into this one. The home crowd's been quiet so far.
Yeah, they have. I'm surprised. That's not normal. This crowd is usually very, very involved.
T-Bird Gym now starting to make some noise. Very quiet that first half. The Zeniths took the air out of the room. Blackmore can't go from the baseline. Here's Moore now on the run to Aloth and can't go. Rebound by number nine, Levi Steed. Blackmore tried. Good steal by Moore. Loose ball now in front of the T-Bird bench. Foul
Body's
called.
On the floor. Wow.
Yeah, we got a little bit of a skirmish there as Long, number five. Blackmore, number five of the Zeniths, has to get moved away. Brady Tollister, number seven, was at the bottom of that pile. So there is a foul called on the T-Birds. And the possession arrow goes to the Zeniths, who have a 9-point lead with just under 9 minutes in this first one. Big foul underneath that Tollister driving down the baseline.
He was all in on that drive. There was no pulling out of that one.
Hold by number five, Michael Long, as he's guilty of the foul. Number seven, Brady Tollister will shoot two. Of course, Magrath, Alberta, did a little research, my own little research during the intermission.
good.
Thank you. Magrath, Alberta, 32 kilometers south of Lethbridge. Population of only 2,200.
Oh, okay. Yep, that sounds kind of like the town that I grew up in.
You, and of course, my analyst, all the way a graduate of Acadia University. A Nova Scotia girl.
Yeah, my hometown is 5,000, but it doubles in population when our university's in session.
There you go, you bet. Probably so. Doubles on a Saturday night like tonight, too.
Yes, somehow it does.
Blackmore now. Had a phenomenal game for the Zeniths. Travel called on number seven, Tollister. He didn't like the call. And again, most people who get caught traveling don't.
I don't think they're going to like anything that goes against them tonight.
That's right.
Everybody wants that nice big trophy to take home.
Of course, earlier tonight, the Jasper Place Rebels captured the senior women's championship here at the 24th annual Totem Hoop Classic, a 66-36 victory. Big victory over St. Albert.
Great attack.
Beautiful feed down low as number 11, Adiola Alupino, gets the easy two down low.
That's just basic basketball, being in the right spot at the right time, just being patient with your feet.
Number nine, that's Levi Steed, who's guilty of the push. That's his third foul of the night. Check that. That is his fourth foul of the night.
Ouch, that hurts.
And Steed has done an amazing job on the glass. So Josh Jensen, the 6'6" center in grade 12 for the Zeniths, he'll check back in. But they're going to miss Levi Steed, who has done an amazing job.
They really are.
On the offensive and defensive glass all night. Steed has been a force back there, but with four fouls, you have to be careful now.
Yeah, we probably won't see him again until the fourth quarter.
7.5 to go here, 14 on the shot clock. T-Birds will inbound. Beautiful feed down to Aloth. Good hustle play by Ross Shep.
Look at those bodies on the floor. Magrath
now
is the first one every time.
Now we got another skirmish going on. That's number 11, Taylor Cook. He's mixed up with Keon Moore.
Shep needs to be the first body to that ball.
Moore with his second foul. And the possession arrow will go to the Zeniths. 9-point lead here, 7:20 at the Ross Shep gym. Good ball movement by the Zeniths, who've shown it all night now. Can the T-Birds cut away at this 9-point lead on their home floor? Put back, beautiful.
Another offensive board, and that is really what the big determining factor has been so far tonight.
Brady Tollestrup with the put back for two. How do the T-Birds answer? Down 11 now.
A little bit late on that post-entry pass. He just waited until the defender got back around the offensive player, and that was too late to be making that pass.
Olapino guilty of the foul. Non-shooting foul.
Looks like they missed a basket for us.
I think they did.
They fixed it.
So it is an 11-point lead, 48-37, with 6:49 to go here in the third quarter. Checking in for the Zeniths is number 8, Mason Stock. He's got three fouls. Number 11, Taylor Cook, comes out of the ball game for Magrath. Nice little spin move and a nice
great
little baby
take.
Hook by Aloth, number 13. Did very well down in the post there. Here's Blackmore, number 5. Good matchup with Moore all night of the T-Birds. Those two guys going toe-to-toe. Here's Tollestrup. He'll spot up for three. Won't go. Rebound, T-Birds. Here's Louis. He tries to step back. Foul called here. T-Birds to inbound, non-shooting foul. Deep in the paint, number 1, Atara Magok.
And all of a sudden that 11-point lead is 7.
But like you mentioned, the T-Birds look to be getting back to sound fundamental basketball. Move the ball, get it down low, and let the big guys, you know, let the big guys get the easy buckets down low.
That's right. They're always going to shoot a higher percentage of layups than threes. There's no question about that.
And Magrath, head coach Danny Balderson, wisely calls a timeout here, because the Thunderbirds right now you're sensing a bit of a momentum change. All of a sudden, the T-Birds working the ball down low, they get some hard-working buckets, and now that lead cut down to 7.
Yep, that 7-point, 4-point swing, it really, really changes how each team is feeling.
Want to thank our viewers for joining us tonight, the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic from Ross Shepherd High School. Great to have you along with us. ICU Video pleased to present this men's division, the senior men's division championship game here in this 24th annual preseason basketball tournament, which has become a holiday hoops tradition at Ross Sheppard High School. Of course, holiday season upon us, and want to wish our viewers a very happy holidays as we enter the silly season, as it were, and exams coming up and school winding to a close for that big two-week break.
Yep.
But
the kids are excited.
Kids are already excited.
In the classrooms.
You bet. And of course, next week, these teams will be in the midst or starting their regular seasons. Mm-hmm. But you wouldn't know it out on this floor, because these two teams are really duking it out tonight. And of course, Ross Shep will be in the Division One. The men's senior team will be in Division One, and that's always an extremely competitive basketball. Edmonton has a great tradition of high school basketball. And Ross Shep, of course, you can't mention high school basketball in Edmonton without mentioning the T-Birds.
That's right.
Back to live action. Down low. And a big finish by number 13, Alath. Alath, who was shooting from the outside in that first half, but now Coach Youngs is starting to feed him down in the post.
You know what? Alath is a great, strong grade 12 presence for the T-Birds. And when they require a score, sometimes it's a lot easier to just find that grade 12 kid who's ready to produce for you.
Feed the big guy, number 13, Alath. Alath, 6'5", the forward, the senior forward in grade 12.
The thing about that three-point shot that Alath does love is that you live by the three, you die by the three. So you got to get a little creative when those aren't dropping for you.
Nice, smooth shot as he converts his.
And now we got ourselves a four-point game.
Now we've got a ball game. Here we go. Zeniths and the T-Birds. Crowd into it. You gotta love it. Oh, here
Excellent.
We go. Big steal by Moore.
You gotta give credit to Medit for that one. I mean, he's just aggression and feet, and he's in the right place at the right time. So that's an excellent hustle play.
Moore will shoot now. Tallestrup, number 7. Guilty of the foul. That's his third, and there's some players in that Zenith lineup that
that's a lot of foul trouble.
Danny Balderson, the head coach, is starting to grow concerned as the fouls pick up. So Moore now.
They only have 9 kids, so if they've already got 4 in foul trouble, they have to really be cautious.
That bench looks awfully short, doesn't it?
Yeah, 9 becomes 5 very quickly.
You bet. Good ball movement by the T-Birds now, sensing momentum change. And a big bucket by Louith. Madit Louith, the youngster, with the hoop and the harm, the grade 10, 6'1" guard from grade 10, with the poise of a veteran. Foul on number 9, Levi Steed. That is his fifth. 5:30 to go here in the third quarter. And Robin, we've got ourselves a tie ball game.
Oh, and that'll happen real fast.
48-48.
Fouling out in the third quarter, that doesn't happen too much. So
number 9, Levi Steed of the Zeniths, who has been doing such a great job in terms of rebounding, picks up his fifth foul. He is out of this ball game. The grade 11 forward, the 6'4" forward from the Zeniths.
So Magrath is now really going to have to clean up their defense, their rotations, their help side, and just make sure that they are taking care of business in that area, because otherwise they are going to be in big trouble.
And Ross Sheppard has their first lead of the ball game, 49-48. Beautiful feed
great
down
answer.
Below.
That is a great answer from Magrath.
Number 8, Mason Stock. The easy 2 down low, but what a hustle play by Magrath. T-Birds now. Here's Moore. Driving, stopping, turns, fires, and buries
great
the 2.
Finish. And you can hear that crowd now. They're a little bit more excited now that the T-Birds are up.
T-Bird Nation has come alive here.
They were just resting.
At the Shep Gym, you bet.
Saving their energy for the third quarter.
That's right. And the hoop will not go. That's number 11, Taylor Cook, with hard work in the paint down low. And with 4:46 to go in the third quarter, Taylor Cook will shoot 2 and try to give the Zeniths a lead in this game. So this thing is going to start to look a little seesawish for a while now. Third quarter here.
Yeah, we're a little early to be shooting a lot of free throws, but I mean, with the physicality and the refs are really trying to hold these boys to staying clean, no dirty play. So I think that we may be hearing a lot of whistles.
Tie game now with that free throw, 51-51. Here at T-Bird Gym, the Totem Hoop Classic 2016 edition. There's Luith down low to Bright, number 9. He loses the handle on the ball. Here's Blackmore, number 5. He'll take over for McGrath. Nice spin move around Moore.
Great reads by Blackmore. He's just a clever player, gets his where he can, and
beautiful,
hey, that's
shot.
Another score. Yep.
Mason
same player.
Stock along the baseline, left alone, and he's going to hit that 15-footer all day. Moore driving, but is called on the travel. Mason Stock along the baseline has been lethal for the Zenits. Zenits now will take over possession. Tallstrup will inbound.
Shep's getting a warning there for touching the ball after it goes in. So they're being informed that they should not be.
That was the shot after mm-hmm. the.
So once they score, they're not allowed to touch the ball again. They need to leave it and get back on defense. There's a lot of post-score play happening on that basketball.
Intensity starting to rise here, both on. You can feel it in the crowd and you can feel it out on the floor. These two teams want this. Championship game, Totem Hoop Classic. Preseason basketball here at Ross Sheppard.
Oh
McGrath
my.
Up, beautiful little run by Blackmore. Rebound Cook.
Oh.
Nice put back by number 7, Brady Tallestrup.
You know what? The great thing about these McGrath players is none of them are shy about a role. They are happy to fill whatever role they need to fill. So whether it's that point guard who's getting pieces of the passes and battling inside, or it's those guys who are getting those rebounds inside to shoot layups, they are happy to fill whatever role is required of them.
Here's a loft now for 3, and it won't go. Fresh clock for the T-Birds. And looks like there will be a foul called on number 8, Mason Stock. Foul committed on Bright, number 9. Stock gets called. That is that's 4th foul for Mason Stock. So once again, Danny Balderson now. This is where for a coach such as yourself, where you really have to start looking at the lineup, looking down the bench and figuring these things out.
I don't know how many kids they have with 4 fouls, but they do already have 1 fouled out. I mean, at this point in the game, it's so difficult because that physicality is present in both directions. But, I mean,
Bright hits his first.
You might have to change your style because right now it's not going well.
What do you do in that case when you do have foul trouble? Defensively, how do you shift things, Robin?
You just have to be more aware of being clean. Like, the way that I would say it to the kids is every single box out has to be clean. Every single rebound has to be clean. Every single steal has to be clean. You can't gamble on anything. There's no room for error. So you have to be just diligent with your hands and diligent with your movement. It's a great
Blackmore,
feed inside.
Beautiful play by Blackmore as he feeds number 13, Josh Jensen.
He sees the floor so well. And for a grade 11, I mean, he's got a big room for improvement for another year.
McGaugh, number 1, and number 6, Grayson Youngs, grade 10 guard.
Little Youngs.
Checks in for the T-Birds. Oh, looks like we've got a... Robin, did you forget to pay the bill? We got lights coming on, but there's a lot of electricity in the building, but none of it working right now.
The trouble with a new facility
is that
there can be things that people don't know about and that light switch is in a bad place.
You bet. Oh, nearly goes, but big rebound by Bradley Bright. And now Luith now will bring it up for the T-Birds. He'll kick it back out. There's a Gawk down low. Good ball movement by Ross Sheff, number 10. Sufjan Noor, the grade 12 forward, 6'3".
And that's going to be five for eight.
Eight now, and that is Mason Stock, number eight of the Zeniths. He'll foul out of this ball game, the 6'3" forward, grade 10 for the Zeniths.
So now McGrath only has three kids left on their bench. Three kids.
This is where you need to get creative here. And number 10, the lefty, Sufjan Noor, misses his first shot. So Danny Balderson with a three-point lead here, but lots of foul trouble to contend with. Rebound now by McGrath. What does McGrath do here, knowing that they've got foul trouble?
They got to just keep playing just like that. Their game can't change offensively. They have to stay aggressive. They have to keep doing the things that are working for them. They just have to be more meticulous with their defense. Oh,
beautiful up and under by number 10, Sufjan Noor. Nice little reverse. Nice answer by the
T-Birds. I think Tur has only half a shoe on. Number one, he's only wearing half his shoe.
That is true. He does only have half a shoe. I'm not sure how.
He needs to be yelling at a referee
right now
to stop the game.
Blackmore spots up.
That's a great shot. Nothing wrong with that.
Rebound by Bright. Here's Louis.
And he's going to fix it. There we go.
Just like that. Good coach, too. Dave Young's telling his player, fix your shoe.
You know what? It's easier to play 4-on-5 on offense than it is on defense.
Isn't that the truth? Here we go. Down low. Bright now pivots. Kicks it back out. And
called for three in the key,
the call.
That was a bit of a messy offensive possession.
Against the Thunderbirds. 1:37 to go in this third quarter. McGrath up by three. Great game so far. Exactly what we anticipated and exactly what we expected between these two teams. McGrath jumped out to a big lead. But the T-Birds have battled back here in this second half.
I think
down by 10 to begin. Sorry, Robin.
Oh, the tough thing right now for McGrath is they have another quarter. There is a whole quarter to play, and with eight bodies, I mean, that's your rotation to begin with, so they are really going to have to be smart with who is on the floor.
It's a long way to go. A
10
very,
minutes
very long
is a long time.
It's an eternity in basketball,
I'll tell you.
That's
right.
1:14 to go here. Number 11, Taylor Cook of the Zeniths will shoot two. Trying to give the McGrath squad a five-point lead here as we approach the final moments of the third quarter.
McGrath is just always in the right place in the right time for those rebounds.
Parker Clifton, number six, kicks it back out. Real creative little play. And the easy lay-in by number 11, Taylor Cook, with a great play at the top of the key.
McGrath travels well. I think they have a whole crowd of people here watching them play. It's pretty great to see. It's a long trip.
Very, very long trip, you bet. Good 5-6 hour journey, and we're so glad so many of the Zenith fans were able to make it up here for the Totem Hoop Classic. Blackmore now. Big enough differential between the shot clock and the game clock, about 18 seconds. Here's Taylor Cook now. Pass won't go underneath. And now number six, Grayson Youngs, will slow things down. Down low, and he feeds it to Hatter McGaugh. Beautiful
pass. I think McGrath was ready for them to just hold it and wait for the end of the quarter here, but that was a great choice in transition for Grayson Youngs.
Blackmore now penetrating, stopping. Going to take a look, going to kick it back out. Here's Clifton for three, and it won't go, just short. But at the end of the third quarter, the McGrath Zeniths lead this one 60-56. Robin, what can we expect? We've seen a little bit of everything tonight.
Oh, my.
What can we expect in this fourth quarter?
I think we're just going to expect more of the same. I think right now McGrath has to have a discussion about body control and what's happening on defense. And, I mean, I hope, honestly, the referees are having a discussion about what's going on with their foul calls, right? I mean, I'm not saying they need to stop calling things. I am saying they need to be cognizant because we're about to have zero bodies left. But I would say just McGrath really needs to be diligent with taking care of their defensive body control.
And you coaches are always so helpful with the referees, too.
I know, we're so kind and thoughtful.
They're always so appreciative of the
That's
extra assistance.
That's what they always say to me.
Is that right? They always commend
Robin,
you.
Robin, you were right. Yeah, no, I'm always right.
You bet.
But I would say for Shep right now, they need to just push in transition. They need to find ways to get Magrath off balance. They need to capitalize on this foul trouble, because if they don't, it's going to just be a continual battle. I mean, they could take Magrath out of the game right now if they play the right type of game.
Also, T-Birds need to get this gym going as well. The Magrath, the Zeniths have kept for the legendary crowd here at the Thunderbird Gym, and Ross Shep fans are well known. You know, this school's been around for 60 mm-hmm, years, mm-hmm. and we talked about the T-Bird tradition in terms of basketball, but this Magrath team has kept this T-Bird crowd very quiet tonight, and it's due in large part to this the hustle, as you mentioned, that Magrath has displayed, and the work on the glass, but also credit to the T-Birds. They've been battling back. They were down by 10 entering the second half, and full credit to Dave Youngs and his team. They settled down after a rough first half, and they've really come out. So we're in for an epic finish, I am sure. There's no two ways about it.
This
is going to be a fun one here. Back to live action now. Magrath here with a 4-point lead. Early seconds of the fourth quarter. Men's final game won't go. The little put away.
Look at that offensive rebounding, though.
T-Birds now on the fast
There's
break.
There's that push in transition.
Big hustle by number 6, Parker Clifton.
And that's what they need to do.
Swats that ball out.
Great, Josh, don't fight, Josh.
Opening 20 seconds here with a 4-point lead. Here in this fourth quarter, the men's senior division of the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic here at Ross Shep High School.
Great shot.
Beautiful shot by Madik
Louis. Had
to
get every part of the rim on that one.
You bet. Smooth turn, smooth delivery by Louis.
Call that a shooter's touch.
Number 7, Brady Tolstorp. He's been all over the floor for Magrath. Clifton now, good ball movement by the Zeniths. Gives it up to Blackmore, 5 on the shot clock. He'll turn, drive, into the paint. Fresh clock for the Zeniths. Can't get it to go off the glass. And the rebound gathered by number 13, Aloth Aloth.
And a foul.
Foul called on number 7. Brady Tolstrup. And 4 fouls, so the Zeniths now keeping close track of the foul count among their players. Here's Louis. He'll drive. Can't get it to go. Rebound by Cook, number 11. Now Clifton, number 6, over to Blackmore. Blackmore, the quarterback of this Zenith offense. Foul committed by number 13, Aloth Aloth.
But right now, Shep needs to be taking those gambles. They're not in foul trouble, so there is nothing to be lost from jumping an extra gap or two.
And they've got a deep bench, too. So, I mean, they do have some bench strength out there as well in terms of numbers. There's number 14, Sam Payne from downtown.
I think he's missed maybe 2 shots tonight. He is quite a hot hand.
Beautiful jump shot by Payne. And Magrath expands that lead to 5 now, 63-58. Payne awfully quiet in that third quarter. Youngs can't get the 3 to go. Put back by the T-Birds. And McGaugh, Atur McGaugh, draws the foul. It's number 7, Tolestrup.
And there's 5.
And there's 5 for Tolestrup. So now the Zeniths, 3 players have fouled out for Magrath. 8:08 to go, and Kim is a coach. Kim's glad she's not coaching this one.
Yep.
She's Kim's thinking about, Robin's thinking about the, check that, Robin. I've been sitting next to you all night. But
it's all good.
It's, it is Robin, by the way. And
I would not like to be coaching this.
No, I was going to say.
It's just, it's so painful when you feel like your boys are doing everything that they can and your players are working hard and they're in the right spots and they're just getting a couple.
There's
whistles.
Payne again with a beautiful, beautiful release in traffic.
He elevates just in the right time. It's nice.
Smooth,
to see.
Smooth, smooth from Sam Payne in that pass. It's number 10, Noor. Tried to find McGaugh across the floor, and McGaugh loses the handle on the basketball. 7:42 now, 6-point lead for the Zeniths. And number 13, Aloth with the near steal, but ball knocked out of bounds, and the Zeniths will inbound with 7:38 to go. And as we mentioned, for a coach, Robin, when you get into that kind of foul trouble, you're really, really, you get into a little bit of desperation mode, too.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I love about number 5 for McGrath? He just does such a good job when he's being overplayed of making a decision about where that defender is. If they body him up, he just spins. It's really nice to see. It's a clever heads-up play from him.
Taylor Cook, number 11, to shoot 2, makes his first. And I mean, really, Payson Blackmore, number 5 of the Zeniths, has just really controlled the pace of the game. He has scored when he's needed to, and he's delivered the ball when he's needed to.
Yeah, he does a great job of just reading those defenders, and he will score if you give it to him, or he will find someone who is open if you give it to him.
Good ball movement here by the T-Birds now as they move it around. Aloth, number 13, he'll stop, looked for the 3. And a jump ball here is Clifton.
That's a big gamble from McGrath to
is
be tying
ever.
That one up, but it paid off for them.
Give possession to the T-Birds. Alath will inbound now. That's Nur, number 10. He'll kick it back out to the point guard. Moore, number 4. Here's Louith. Back out to Moore. Near step back 3. Here's Louith for 3. Great 10 forward won't go. And McGrath with the rebound. That's number 13, Josh Jensen. And at this point, if you're Ross Shep, you're also trying to draw fouls, too, because
that's
the
right.
Zeniths are in foul trouble.
That's
you're
right.
Trying to draw fouls no matter what you do.
Yes, there's no question that they really.
Oh, and it can't go. Number 13, Josh Jensen.
They really, really want to be pounding it inside to just try and find something that is going to get the refs to blow that whistle. I mean, there are things to be said about trying to make the ref blow a whistle, but right now that would be so much in Ross Shep's favor.
Aloth for 3, couldn't get it to go. Now McGrath back up the floor. Here's Sam Payne again.
Oh, my.
From the corner for 3. What a shot.
And that
by
celebration.
Sam Payne. 10-point
that
lead
is merited.
For McGrath. 6:21 to go, and Sam Payne, who has hit 3 big shots and none bigger than that 3 from the corner. He has been lethal. Quiet in the third quarter, but now it's Shep is going to have to spy on him eventually.
I think that the great thing that we're seeing right now with McGrath, and it's pretty impressive to be honest with you, because he has been a player all game. He has been scoring all game. But it wasn't until this last quarter where we are really seeing them go to him, and he's patient. He's not forcing anything. He hasn't taken a single shot that wasn't within the flow of their offense, and that's a great thing to see. That is discipline from a coach.
He's made shots when he's had open looks. He's made shots in traffic. He has made shots with two guys in his face.
Yes.
Sam Payne has really delivered. Now, as we talked about, we got to talk about foul trouble.
Uh-huh.
Sam Payne has got 4 fouls. So I think just about everybody on the Zeniths has 4 fouls.
Yeah.
But right now, it's going to come down to Payson Blackmore, isn't it?
Yes.
Ultimately. He's been the engine of the Zeniths all night. It's going to come down to his defense and him leading the offense. So
you have to be impressed. You don't see a lot of point guards like Blackmore. He is just clever and intuitive, and he is patient, patient, patient. That is so important for a point guard. So he is going to be the determinant, I think, for this game.
Shep now, 6 minutes to go.
That's a big shot.
McGawk with a big two, the 6'3" guard, the grade 11 guard for the T-Birds. Lead down to eight. Now here's Payne for three again.
They left him open.
Wide open.
Didn't
Sam
you just scout
Payne.
That? You just scouted that.
I just
that.
Scouted that somehow. I don't
know
how I did that.
Someone's got to face guard him.
I'll tell you, you can't leave him alone because he is just going to kill you.
Yep. I mean, really.
Oh, what a play. Beautiful feed down low, number 10.
What
Sufjan
they should do is play a straight up five, but put a face guard on 14 and just don't let him catch the ball. That's what I would do right now.
There's Blackmore now spotting up, and the Zenits cannot miss right now.
They're
between Blackmore and Payne.
They're feeling it.
Right now, the Zenits are in the same type of groove they were in the first quarter. Louith now for the T-Birds. T-Birds need to regain the momentum here.
Great
Louis,
hesitation.
Beautiful step over and nearly a three. Big rebound by Taylor Cook, number 11. Taylor Cook with three fouls.
And Shep really needs a stop here. They need to be diligent with their hands and very precise on
what
defense.
What a drive by number five.
Great read.
Payson Blackmore, 4.5 minutes to go.
And Blackmore allows himself a little smile on that one. I think he's pretty happy with that finish.
Here's Clifton with the steal now for the Zenits. He'll stop. And Blackmore, who else with the rebound, tries to kick it back out. Loose ball in the T-Birds game possession. Here's Aloth, can't get it to go. Rebound by Taylor Cook. And
good
the Zenith
patience.
Bench, Balderson begging. Slow things down. really good pace right here, but Magrath now with a 13-point lead, 4 minutes to go. You want to slow things down. Here's Payne again.
Oh.
Misses the three.
Wanted it.
You bet. Misses that three with McGawk right in his face.
We got to see Magrath now really slow the tempo and really become just patient, just waiting for this game to end. The last 4 minutes here, this is in their advantage. They want to get rid of the time on the clock. They want long possessions.
Nice reverse down the baseline by number 13, Aloth, Aloth.
Good call on the timeout.
Magrath Zenith's called timeout here.
I think Coach Balderson is seeing his boys just get a little tired, and right now there's 3.5 left. You need that energy for the end of the game, so this is the best time to be taking a timeout, have a quick chat with your boys about just calming down and slowing the tempo.
3.5 minutes to go. The Magrath Zenith's here. We can call this an upset. We can call this a pretty good upset when you talk about the number of guys they had. Only a 10-man team for Magrath.
Yeah.
Three players have fouled out.
Yeah.
So what a performance here, as you mentioned, with under 4 minutes to go. The Zeniths here with an 11-point lead, 76-65. The men's championship game of the Totem Hoop Classic ICU Video. Proud to bring you this presentation. I'm Kevin Donnan along with Robin Fleckenstein, my analyst, and Connor O'Donovan on camera. Want to thank our viewers for joining us here in this capacity crowd here at the T-Bird Gym.
Over capacity.
3:34 to go in this highly entertaining. This has been a fantastic, this is exactly what you want for a championship game.
Yeah.
And we talked that this is one of the best preseason tournaments in Western Canada. This looks like a mid-season tournament, I'll tell you. It's been a lot of fun. Here's Moore now for the T-Birds. Pressure defense on Blackmore. These two have battled it out all night. Now Blackmore drives, stops. Rebound now by the T-Birds, kick back out.
But they got a score. That was not a change in possession, so the shot clock did not change.
Shot clock down to two, and they get a fresh clock. Aloth with the rebound. Now Moore will run for the T-Birds and drive.
Oh, my.
Big rejection, number six, Parker Clifton. Following the play.
5'10", he looked a lot more like 6'10".
And Grayson Youngs can't get the putback to go out. Down to Aloth. And he'll clean things up. He gets the feed from Youngs. But I'll tell you, late in a game when you need a big play and you're tired and you've got three guys fouled out, boy, Clifton made the play of the ball game right there.
That was a great energy and hustle play. And like you said, you know, there's not a lot of bodies left here on the McGrath bench. So to see an energy play like that is really exciting.
Good drive by Cook, number 11.
Yep, that's a great call. You know, the defender was there. He was set.
Number 11, Adiola Alupino had position. And the charge against Taylor Cook. That is his fourth foul. And
Do you feel like a broken record?
Yeah. I was going to say, we have fouls. We're giving out fouls all over the place tonight. Alupino, though, with good defensive positioning, takes the charge, and the T-Birds have got some work to do here. 9 points. Big three. Number four, Keon
six.
Moore.
Two possession game. This is anybody's game. Just got to be a decision to take care of that ball. McGrath has to continue looking to score. I think right now they're a little bit back on their heels because of the difference.
Sam.
Oh, my.
But there's the difference.
That's what they need, right?
Sam Payne is the difference right now. 8-point lead. Under two to go.
McGrath has to continue to play.
And can't get the...
to score. They have to continue to look to score every possession.
Foul on, well, we got to get the call here.
14.
Foul on, we believe it's number 14, Sam Payne. Aloth, number 13, will shoot two here. 1:52 to go. You can feel the intensity rising here at the T-Bird Gym. That's still the fifth foul for Taylor Cook. So Taylor Cook will foul out. Sam Payne will stay in. 1:52 to go. Aloth will now shoot his second. So when you get into this kind of foul trouble.
I'm just trying to follow what's happening
I was just going
right
to say
now.
There's a lot of. There's a lot of negotiations going on here. Okay, so now we've got the officials. So we've got a bit of an issue here. The officials trying to decide who committed that foul, but it's key because Taylor Cook's got four.
So 14 is now out.
Sam Payne has been
fouled
out. Taylor Cook is still in. He only has four fouls, but that is Sam Payne's fifth. Only four, yeah. And I'll tell you, this is
four players fouled out for McGrath.
On a 10-person team, so one is going to be the longest minute 52 of the Zenith season, I would think. There's John Jones, the fresh legs from the bench.
They got to get it over.
Big press by the T-Birds.
Oh my. Bodies are everywhere right
now. Relentless, I'll tell you. The Zenith's working hard. Look at Blackmore going up against Moore.
And that's a foul on Keon.
Blocking foul on Keon Moore with a minute and a half to go. 7-point lead for McGrath. T-Birds
McGrath
on the press.
McGrath does need to shoot, though. They are like they can't just dribble out a minute 35. There are a lot of possessions left.
Jones now to Clifton. Number six, the heart of this McGrath team here in this fourth quarter. You think he wants it. Cook now kicks it back out to Jones. And Jones takes that little extra step, 78-71, 126.
Got to brush that one off.
Temperature rising in the T-Bird Gym. And Coach Dave Youngs calls a timeout with just under.
I believe we're just under 120 left.
Just under 120. So great to have you along with us, Kevin Dawn, and with Robin Fleckenstein here, the head coach of the T-Bird Junior women's team. And quickly, Robin, Danny Balder said, quickly, what's he saying to his team right now with 120 to go, 7-point lead, but all of this foul trouble, what's he saying?
Well, if we look at 120, we're saying that's roughly three possessions. So if we now have a T-Birds possession and you're up by seven, So they have to force three possessions. Even if they score a three this possession and they score a three next possession, they still need another possession. So if you are diligent with holding the ball and with creating long possessions, you should be able to sweat this one out. But if I was Coach Young's, I'd be saying the exact opposite. We need scores and we need them quick. We need easy looks and right away. And we need turnovers. You're right. Yeah, exactly. So the question is, does Coach Young's go to a foul and make them have a free throw competition strategy? Or does he go with, we are just going to score and then put the pressure on?
Here's one thing our viewers can't do, and that's move a muscle. Don't go anywhere. 1:23 to go. Great to have you here. Men's Division Championship game, 2016 Totem Hoop Classic. Here we go. Live action, number four. Keon Moore steps back. Outside the arc now, kicks it back out. Here's Youngs for three. Number six, way off. Rebound by the Zeniths. 1:11 to go now. Here's Blackmore, number five. Spins away from Luith. He'll drive now.
Oh, my.
Oh, and the lay-in will not go for Blackmore. Big rebound now.
That's a good shot, though. That's a good shot to get.
Here's Moore now trying to draw a foul. He'll kick the three out to Youngs.
Yep.
And a big three from downtown.
That's the shot that they need.
T-Birds now within four, 78-74, 48 seconds to go. Here's Blackmore. Gets it over half. Gathers the ball now. Moore, tough defense by the T-Birds. Blackmore now steps back, and the foul. Moore with the reach in, 36.7 to go.
They still do have, that was their foul to give, so they're still not shooting free throws on this.
One foul to give here before we get into team fouls.
And that would be Keon's fifth.
And that is Keon Moore's fifth foul, so he will foul out of this ball game, and he has played. He can be very proud of his effort tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Keon Moore, number four, strong on defense.
I don't think he was aware of his foul situation, or else I think he would have been more diligent with his defense.
Number two, Munir Amar will check in, the 5'10", grade 11 guard, 36.7. Live action now, Jones will inbound. Here's Blackmore, number five. He'll stop, pop for three, won't go. Rebound now, T-Birds rebound, under 30 to go.
They need a
78-74.
Oh my.
Loose ball now, Aloth will kick it back out. McGough misses the three. Loose ball. Foul on the play.
And the same thing that they got called for there early in the first half, Alath just tried to go right through that defender who was doing a great job of boxing him out.
Foul called on number 13, Aloth. Aloth, the 6'5" forward in grade 12, 16.1, 4-point game.
McGrath must be out of timeouts, or else I think they would call one to advance the ball.
Zeniths now, 14 seconds, 4-point game. Blackmore, T-Birds close in. Foul on Grayson Young's number six, 4-point game, 12 seconds left.
That's going to be shooting.
And it is a shooting foul. And Payson Blackmore, the wrong guy to have at the line with 12.2 to go.
The right guy for McGrath, the
right
wrong guy
that's
for
right.
The T-Birds.
That's right. And Blackmore misses his first 4-point game, 12.2. Fantastic championship game here at T-Bird Gym.
T-Birds need a three now in transition. They're going to have to find a shooter.
Blackmore hits it to make it a 5-point game.
Take the timeout to advance the ball. That's a smart play by Coach Youngs.
Good timeout called by Coach Youngs of the T-Birds. Be a 5-point game here with 12.2 to go. And Robin, this has been an absolutely fun one to watch.
Oh, yeah.
This, like we were talking, McGrath, they make the, well, basically 5-6 hour journey. They come up here and in that first half dominated the offensive glass. T-Birds came back, started to hit some big threes, some big shots. But in this fourth quarter, the Zeniths have really responded, and especially, and I know we were kind of having some fun with it, but What a great job coaching by Danny Balderson in terms of with managing his bench, managing these fouls, because at some point we needed an accountant to figure out how many fouls McGrath
had. I don't think that would have helped us either.
No.
Think nobody knew what was going on.
Exactly.
The refs were
trying to figure out who.
Correcting each other.
Exactly. But I'll tell you, what a great evening it's been. Earlier this evening, the Jasper Place Rebels took the women's senior crown here at the Totem Hoop Classic. Mm-hmm. And we obviously, we want to throw a shout out to all of the many volunteers, the staff volunteers, the student volunteers, everyone who has made this tournament happen. They have just done a phenomenal job here at Ross Shep. And as I've said, Ross Shep is the birthplace of basketball in Edmonton for high school. And they didn't disappoint with in terms of organization and putting on a great show.
I think we should trademark that.
You bet. I think, yeah.
We can have that from you?
Oh, sure.
I like it.
For a nominal fee. Here we go. Here we go. Elite. Oh, and a big rejection. Payson Blackmore. Here's for the three. Won't go. Rebound. Kicks it back on another three. Won't go for the T-Birds. Under 2 seconds left and the foul. And the Magrath Zeniths are on their way to the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic men's senior title.
Yep.
What a ball game, Robin.
Oh, my. You know what? That was
what a performance.
A tough one there at the end. I think they got three opportunities out of three, and sometimes the ball is just not going to fall for you. So
shooting foul for Josh Jensen. He'll shoot his second here with 0.7 seconds to go. So here's Jensen. He'll make it a 6-point game. But what he'll do is he will finalize an 80-74 victory for the visiting Magrath Zeniths, who take down the Ross Sheppard Thunderbirds in the men's division final here, the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic. And this championship game was a classic, Robin. Mm-hmm.
So impressive. You know what? That is just a great show of teamwork here from the Magrath Zeniths, and they did a fantastic job of playing through some real adversity tonight.
And you always think, boy, that's going to be a long drive home, but it's not going to be a long.
Not for them, not tonight.
No, that 5-6 hour drive home is going to be a fun one going down south.
They are not going to mind one bit.
No, it's not going to be a quiet, drive either, I'm sure, for the first little while.
Yeah,
anyway,
you're right. I would agree with that.
And full credit to head coach Danny Balderson and. I think if we're picking players of the game, if we start with the victorious team, if we start with Magrath, I don't think we have to look. It's either Sam Payne.
I think
it may be more difficult than I think. I think we could honestly bring out, there's got the wood shop here has got to be open, so maybe we can cut that thing in half and give half the trophy to Sam Payne and half the player of the game to Payson Blackmore, because those two were absolutely lethal. Sam Payne, his teammates are just swarming him right now in terms of not just hitting shots, but clutch shots.
Yes.
And shots that really, when it was time to make a big shot, Sam Payne was there in this 80-74 victory.
Yeah.
Really heavy shots in traffic. It was just a fantastic performance.
Yeah. I'm so impressed. I just have nothing else
to
say.
Yeah, and it's not easy coming in. You're coming in from out of town. We talked about that long drive.
Yeah.
Magrath, as we talked about, 2,200 people in that town. But boy,
they must all play basketball.
It's the capital of basketball in southern Alberta, I got to say, and what a fantastic performance.
But I have to say, like, Sam Payne was, yes, clutch and phenomenal, but there's no question that Blackmore is just
absolutely. And I think Ross Shep here, we're going to give out some hardware here. The Thunderbirds, of course, had can't say anything. You know, the Thunderbirds had a fantastic performance, came up a little short, maybe the nerves kicked in, but this is a good thing going forward for them going into the season in terms of adversity, pressure, all of those sorts of things. So we can expect lots of good things out of the men's team here at Ross Shep.
You know what? We always say this to the girls at the beginning of the season, especially when there's a tough loss like like this, but you're not preparing for a game in December.
Right.
Nobody cares about these games. Like, yeah, it does suck to lose. It always sucks to lose. But this is not what the goal is. The goal is March. So if you learn from today and you learn to go forward, March is what they're looking at. So
player of the game here
was Keon.
Player of the game was Keon.
Mm-hmm. Or, sorry, like the all-star for the tournament.
Okay. And the runner-up trophy being presented to, that's being presented to Bashar Kamal, the grade 12 forward, the 6'2 grade 12 forward. So Ross Shep can put their name on the runner-up trophy, and now we will have medal presentations to the Ross Shep Thunderbirds, and they put in a whale of an effort. I'll tell you, they had a lot. I mean, number four, Keon Moore, was a huge part of the Thunderbird offense. Mm-hmm. Aloth hit some big shots, did some great work on the outside, and did some good work down on the baseline as well.
Yeah, very impressive effort from really everyone who played for the T-Birds tonight. They left their heart on the floor. And
we can expect good things out of this T-Bird men's team going in. They're in the 15-team Division One, so every game they're going to play this season is going to be ultra competitive, because they're in there with Jasper Place, they're in there with Harry Ainley, so they're in for a very very good season and a very competitive season. And we want to wish the McGrath Zeniths all the luck in their season. And what a great start. To win a preseason tournament on the road, you come up here and then and you win big, 80-74,
mm-hmm.
And what a great way to start their season. So, as I say, more hardware handed out as McGrath will receive, and no surprise, it, as you mentioned, it is Payson Blackmore with a great performance. And the trophy presentation.
He's named to the
All-Star team.
All-Star team. This is our MVP.
And Sam Payne, the MVP of the tournament. And certainly what a performance in this game in terms of clutch shots, big threes. And in that fourth quarter, those three shots that Sam Payne hit were the difference in the ballgame in terms of momentum and in terms of giving that team a lift. And here we go with the trophy presentation, the 2016 Totem Hoop Classic Men's Champions, the McGrath Zeniths. So congratulations to Danny Balderson, his staff, and his students for a tremendous performance. And on behalf of my colleague Robin Fleckenstein and our cameraman Connor O'Donovan, want to thank you for joining us this evening and throughout this entire tournament. ICU Video, of course, we do not podcast, we procast, and we broadcast amateur sports professionally, and we have been so pleased and so proud to bring you the action of the Totem Hoop Classic here in 2016. Want to thank everyone for joining us tonight. My name is Kevin Donnan. Thank you for joining us, and have a pleasant evening from the T-Bird Gym in beautiful downtown Edmonton. Good night, everybody.